This time, optimization starts before we start the game. If your CPU supports resizable bar or smart access memory, you should turn it on. It improves performance in Cyberpunk. I also recommend you overclock the graphics card. It will give you slightly better performance. My test system has PCIe 4.0. It's a Ryzen 5900X paired with 16 GB of DDR4 3200 C14 RAM. And I'm running Windows 11. In-game, I'm using slightly downwards tuned medium preset with medium textures and ultra quality FSR. Although there's another option here. We'll talk about that in a second. Choose crowd density according to your CPU, but most PCIe 4.0 capable CPUs should handle medium crowd density. The frame rate is solid. In rare cases, it can drop about 45, but usually we're around 60. In some cases, we can hit as high as 90 FPS. Optimizing for the 6500 XT is a balancing act. It's easy to sell yourself short and have the game look too potato-y, or overdo it and get bad performance. The other option is dynamic resolution scaling instead of FSR 1.0 ultra quality. As a side note, when they update the game to FSR 2.0, I recommend the quality setting at 1080p. When using dynamic scaling for a 60 FPS target, I recommend you set the actual target a bit higher. I use 62 FPS, and then I limit the FPS to 60 using dynamic scaling. The frame rate will be more stable than when you use FSR, but we allow the game to look worse in some instances. On a 60Hz display, I might go for the dynamic scaling approach. On a higher refresh monitor, I'd go the FSR route. If you want to know more about overclocking the RX 6500 XT, check out this video here. If this video was helpful, consider giving it a like, and check out my channel page if you're new here.